Welcome to my class Pinnacle of English. In today's class, we are going to learn a very good poem from class 9 CBSE. The title of the poem is A Legend of Northland, which is written by Phoebe Cary. Let's understand the introduction of the poem. A Legend of the Northland is a ballad. Now let's understand the meaning of ballad. Ballad is a long narrative poem in short stanzas. It is such kind of poem which tells a story in short stanzas, and in the poem all the stanzas are comprises of four lines. In total there are 16 stanzas in this poem, and all these stanzas will tell us a story. So, in ballad, we can find a moral story which children can learn from this poem. There is a moral value we can find in that. Students even can learn life skills from this poem. So, ballad is a long narrative poem which is decorated with very good vocabulary by the poet. So, ballads are a part of folk culture or popular culture and are passed on orally from one generation to the next. Folk culture is a story of any area and is known as ballad. So, folk story, it may be from any regional language, but if it is written in a poem, that poem is called a ballad. Folk culture comprises of traditional stories which are passed on from one generation to the other generation. This story is of the Northland area, the area which is near the North Pole. The poet has not specified any particular area in Northland. It means the area in the northernmost part of the earth, near the earth pole. Legend means a historical story, one which is very old and has been passed from one generation to other generation. Now let's understand the entire poem with stanzas. Stanza number 1. Away, away in Northland, where the hours of the day are few and the nights are so long in winter that they cannot sleep from them. It is too much far in the Northland. The poet has not specified any particular place. Where the hours of the day are few means the daytime is too late, but the winter is too long. Winter time, we can find the nights over there, the nights are too long. That they cannot sleep through them through. So here the poet is talking about the introduction of the poem with the Northland, a place where the hours of the day are very less and the nights are so long in winter, but they cannot sleep long hours in winter season. In line number 3 and 4, line number 3 continues with line number 4, which is showing there is no end, there is no full stop, or there is no comma at all. So line number 3 is continuing with line number 4. So the figure of speech is called enjambment. Stanza number 2. Where they harness the swift reindeer to the sledges when it snows and the children look like bear cubs in their funny furry clothes. In this stanza number 2, the poet is talking about the place where there is too much snowfall. and the reindeer, which can run fast in the snow area. And these reindeers are harnessed with sledges when it snows. And even the children sitting in the sledges, they look like bear's cubs, because during the winter season it is too much cold. So people from Northland, they take much care of their children and they make them wear jackets which are full of fur, and they look like bear's cub. Question line number 3 and 4. Line number 3 is continue with line number 4. Hence, the figure of speech is called enjambment. Stanza number 3. They tell them a curious story. I don't believe it's true, and yet may learn a lesson if I tell the truth to you. In stanza number 3, the poet is talking about a very curious story. But the poet doesn't believe that whether it is true or not. I don't believe. The poet does not believe it's a true story. But then also, from this story, the readers may learn a very good lesson if the poet tells us a very good story. Stanza number 4. Once, when a good Saint Peter lived in the world below and walked about it preaching, just as he did, you know. So once upon a time, there was a Saint Peter. He lived in the world below, means he was living in the world, on the earth, and he was moving here and there, and his work was to preach the people, to give the people very good ideas, very good thoughts about God. That was his motto. Just as he did, that was his work, as we know. Stanza number 4. He came to the door of a cottage. In traveling round the earth, where a little woman was making cakes and baking them on the hearth. So while moving from one place to another place, he reached to the door of a cottage where a little woman was living in it. And in traveling round the earth, there was a little woman inside the cottage. She was making cakes and baking all the cakes on the hearth. Stanza number 6. And being faint with fasting, for the day was almost done, he asked her from her store of cakes to give him a single one. So he moved from one place to another place throughout the day, and without having food, he was fainting because he did not take even a single food in the stomach. Whole day was over and it was evening time. He reached to the door of the little woman and he asked her to give a piece of cake to him, a single one. Stanza number 7. So she made a very little cake, but as it baking lay, she looked at it and thought it seemed too large to give away. So, as per the Saint Peter asked her to give a single piece of cake, she made a very little cake for him, right, and started baking it on the hearth. But after making it, she looked at it and thought it is too large to give to Saint Peter. So she became very much greedy. She did not want to give a piece of cake which she made for Saint Peter. She did not want to give. Therefore, she needed another. She had in the mind that she had to make one more piece of cake, one more cake for Saint Peter. So she made one more cake for Saint Peter, and still a smaller one than the earlier one. But it looked, when she turned it over, as large as the first one had done. So she thought that the first one she prepared that was too large to give to Saint Peter. Then after she decided to make another, she tried her best. And it was little smaller one. But after baking it, she turned it over and thought that this cake is too large as the first had done. Stanza number 9. Then she took a tiny scrape of dough and rolled it flat and baked it thin as a wafer. But she couldn't part with that. Then she took a small, very small piece of dough and then after started making roll and roll and roll and made it flat. It was looking like a wafer. So here in this line the poet is compared that cake with a wafer. So the figure of speech is called simile because comparing word like or as is given. Hence, the figure of speech is called simile. But she couldn't part with that. Even she did not want to give the wafer one to that Saint Peter. She was very much greedy. She did not want to give a single cake, a piece of cake even, to Saint Peter. For she said, "My cakes that seem too small. My cakes are looking very small. When I eat of them myself, are yet too large to give away." So she put them on the shelf. She was very much selfish. She was very much greedy. And she said that, "My cakes are very small. When I eat all the cakes for myself, then yet too large to give away. And these cakes are too big that all these cakes cannot be given to Saint Peter." So she put all the cakes for herself and she put all the cakes on the shelf. Now come to stanza number 11. Then good Saint Peter grew angry, for he was hungry and faint, and surely such a woman was enough to provoke a saint. Then Saint Peter became very much angry because he did not have food, he was fainting, he did a fast, and then he was asking a single piece of cake to have his stomach. But the little woman did not give, so he became very much angry. And surely such a woman was enough to provoke a saint. And this kind of ladies on the earth definitely make a saint angry. And he said, "You are far too selfish, dwell in a human form, to have faith food, to have both food and shelter, and fire to keep you warm." He said very clearly that you are too much selfish to live, to resident, to be a resident on this earth in a human form. And you have everything, food, shelter, and even fire is also there in your house to keep your body warm. So, Saint Peter became very much angry and he cursed her. "Now you shall build as birds do. You should turn to a bird as the birds are doing, finding food, finding residence, and shall get your scanty food. You will get little food then. By boring and boring and boring." Here in this line, you can find repetition because boring word is repeated in this line. So, he's saying that now you have to do as other birds are doing. And you have to get your little food by digging hole in the wood. Stanza number 14. Then up she went through the chimney, never speaking a word, and out of the top flew a woodpecker, for she was chains to a bird. Then she flew up through the chimney. She turned into a woodpecker. And never speaking a word, no expressions are at all afterwards. And out of the top flew. Nobody else but a woodpecker was there. So a little woman changed into a woodpecker, for she was changed to a bird because Saint Peter cursed her. She had a scarlet cape on her head, and that was left the same, but all the rest of her clothes were burnt black as a coal in the flame. So here line number 3 and 4 continue. So enjambment is there. Then next is the black color is compared with a coal. So this is again simile is there. So she had a scarlet, very gaudy, very attractive cap was there, and that was on her head, and that was only left on her head. But the rest of her other clothes that were burnt became black just like a coal in the flame. Stanza number 16. And every country school boy has seen her in the wood where she lives in the trees till this very day, boring and boring for food. So in this last and final stanza, the poet is talking about friend Anne. The school children can see this woodpecker in the forest, in their surrounding areas, and even in the wood where she lives in the trees from that day. And what was her work? Her work was to boring and boring for food. Again, in the fourth line, we can find repetition. Then line, so here all the stanzas are over. I hope you have understood all the description, all 16 stanzas well. Let's understand summary of the poem. The poem is a legend about an old lady who angered Saint Peter because of her greed. The story goes on like this. One day, Saint Peter was preaching around the world and reached to the door of a cottage where the woman said, where the woman was living over there. She was making cakes and baking them on a hearth. Saint Peter was fainting with hunger. He did not have food throughout the day. He asked the lady to give him a piece of cake. The bake that she was baking then appeared to be too long, so she did not give him that, and instead she baked another smaller one that also appeared to be big, so she did not give him that also. The second time she baked yet another smaller cake but found it too big to give away. In the third attempt she took an extremely little scrap of dough and rolled it flat. She had it as thin as a wafer, but was unable to part with that also. This angered Saint Peter a lot. He said that she was not fit to live in human form and enjoy food and warmth. He cursed her and transformed her into woodpecker, bird who had to bore in hard, dry wood to get his scanty food. She can be seen in the trees all day, boring and boring for food. Now let's understand NCERT important questions. Which country or countries do you think the Northland refers to? The Northland could refer to any extremely cold country in the Earth's North Polar region, such as Greenland, the northern regions of Russia, Canada, Norway, etc. Question number two. What did Saint Peter ask the older lady for? What was the lady's reaction? Saint Peter asked the old lady for one of her baked cakes to satisfy his hunger. The lady tried to bake a small cake for Saint Peter. How did he punish her? He asked like this. He punished the old lady by changing her into a woodpecker that built as birds do and gathered scanty food by boring in the hard dry wood all day long. Question number four. How does woodpecker get her food? The woodpecker gets her food by boring holes into the trees. Question number five. Do you think that the old lady would have been so ungenerous if she had known who Saint Peter really was? What would she have done then? Answer of this question is no, the old lady would not have been so ungenerous if she had known who Saint Peter really was. Instead, she would have tried to make him happy with her cakes for the fulfillment of her greedy desires. Question number six. Is this a true story? Which part of this poem do you feel is the most important? No, this is not a true story. It is a legend. I feel the point of the story where the old lady is changed into woodpecker is the most important. This is because the punishment meted out to the lady teaches us the value of generosity and charity. So these two moral values are there. We have to be generous with the people and we have to do some charity work. Question number seven. What is a legend? Why is this poem called a legend? Answer. A legend is a popular story from the past which is believed by many, but one cannot prove whether it is true or not. It usually contains a message or a moral and is narrated to children. The poet himself says that he doesn't believe this tale to be true. This poem is called legend because it preaches generosity towards fellow beings. So we are ending our video. I hope you have liked my video. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Click on like button. Click on bell button for more notifications. And even share with your friends so that they can also get knowledge. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.